Smartest thing I could do right now is leave Houston.
No, that wouldn't be smart. If you know what's best for you, you'll get that idea right out of your head.
But I'm through with Ruby, Mr. H. I even told her I'd give her the divorce.
That's your problem.
But don't you see my cover's blown? I mean, if I hang around Houston any longer, people will start asking questions.
You can handle it.
How?
You have a job to do.
I know that. I just don't see how it can be done now.
What makes you say that?
I don't think we're going to be able to locate the target.
We've already found him.
You know where he is?
Right here in Houston. The rest is up to you.
I think I'm going to live through it. Do we have any more appointments today, honey? No, I don't think so. Something wrong? I can't stop thinking about it, Paige.
What?
That mock-up you're going to make from one of my sketches.
Well, feel good about it.
I'm trying to. I'm scared people are going to laugh at it.
Oh, that won't happen either.
You know, you've been great. I really appreciate what you've been doing.
Well, it's my pleasure.
I hope so.
I just wish you had a little more self-confidence, kiddo.
Yeah, I wish I did, too. Well, I better go home, get ready for my dinner date.
Are you a little nervous about seeing Billy Joe?
Yeah, a little. I know Billy Joe's not going to be happy until I move back in with him.
And you've definitely decided against that.
Definitely.
Nita, what? Will you wait here a minute?
Sure.
Okay, be right back.
All right, Madam Lazanga. What kind of Christmas message do you have for me today? A heart with swords going through it. Thanks a lot.
Rita, what do you think of this outfit, hon?
Oh, gosh, it's my favorite from the collection.
There isn't one you like better, right?
Oh, not a one. It's yours.
What? I'm giving it to you as a present.
No, I couldn't accept it, Paige.
Well, just think of it as an end-of-the-year bonus. You really helped me make a go of this boutique, Nita. Thank you.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
You can wear it on your date tonight.
I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. Just go try it on.
Ow! I'll be right back.
You girls still here?
Hold your horses, Billy Joe. We'll be out in a minute.
I'm ready. I'm just waiting for Ruby.
You know, Ruby, you could have straightened things up around here a little bit.
Why? I think the place looks fine.
I'm having a dinner guest tonight.
Yeah, Nita. As if she hasn't seen it before, Billy Joe. She used to live here.
It doesn't make any difference. This is a special night.
You know, I think this whole thing is a crazy idea. You getting back together with Nita.
I think it's a wonderful idea.
Well, see there? Lurleen thinks it's a wonderful idea.
What are you going to have for dinner tonight, Billy Joe?
Well, the last time that Nita moved back in with me was after I made the delicious Mexican dinner. So guess what I'm going to do?
Fix the same thing.
That's right. I'm going to try to recreate that magical night to the last detail.
Oh, brother.
Now, what's wrong with you?
Nothing. I'm just a little skeptical, that's all.
You don't think it's going to work, do you?
Uh-uh.
Well, I think it will. I'm going to have candlelight and soft music, too.
Lurleen, honey, I think that's our cue to exit.
Now, don't hurry back.
Don't worry, we won't. We'll call first.
Yeah, you do that.
This is for good luck.
Thanks, Lurleen. Well, now, place doesn't look so half bad now. Nita, honey, it's going to be one night you're not going to forget.
You tracked our man here to Houston. Where is he?
Joe, we have a little problem there.
What kind of a problem?
We found him all right, but we lost him again.
You lost him?
During the storm last week.
What's the storm got to do with it?
Everything.
Great. Well, we're right back where we started.
Not quite. Now we know he's in this area.
Then I'm supposed to locate him, is that it?
You'll need this.
Covered all the main points of your aunt's will, Mrs. Marshall, at least those things that concern you. Have you any questions?
What?
Do you have any questions?
No.
I do.
Yes, Mr. Marshall.
You said that in order for Mrs. Marshall to claim her inheritance, she had to take custody of her sister Allison and her cousin Gregory. Now,
of course, you'll have to agree to that too, Mr. Marshall.
Agree to what?
To take custody of Mrs. Marshall's sister until she comes of age, and to legally adopt Gregory.
You mean we have to legally adopt Gregory?
Well, yes, you do. I thought you understood that.
No, I didn't understand that.
Well, you'll have to go through the usual procedure of adoption, but there'll be no problems. I've already started proceedings for you.
You have?
Have they already been informed about this?
Oh, yes. They've already made plans to fly to Houston tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Isn't that quick?
Well, it seemed the best thing to do.
You mean to tell us?
Justin, sweetheart, now, did you not tell me that there is a trust fund that Aunt Hilly set up for both Allison and Gregory?
I just read that part of the will to you, Mrs. Marshall.
I know that, Mr. Farnsworth, but what I'm saying is, doesn't that give them some degree of independence?
When they come of age, it will. But Gregory's only 10 years old, and Allison...
I know how old my sister is, Mr. Farnsworth.
You all have to understand that your aunt's chief concern was for their care.
Well,
and she was certain that they would receive that from you and your husband.
Of course, Mr. Farnsworth. I have a question for you that may seem a little strange.
I rather doubt that, Mrs. Marshall. I've been handling wills for many years, and beneficiaries generally ask the same things.
Go ahead and ask a question, Ashley.
The money that I'll be inheriting in the will, can I use that money as collateral to secure a loan, even though the will is in probate?
No. Certainly could. Thanks to my meticulous handling of Mrs. Linden's estate. Well, if that's everything, I'll be going back to my hotel. I'll see you before I leave.
When will that be?
Tomorrow.
Oh, Mr. Farnsworth. Thank you.
Goodbye, Miss Marshall.
Thank you very much. Believe this?
What?
My aunt leaving me $40 million
and two kids.
Elliot, I hope you don't mind my asking, but why does my mother want to check on Bo Baker?
Well, he's been hired as an assistant producer on the Billy Joe Wright show. She obviously wants to know what his qualifications are.
And you haven't been able to find out anything about it?
Not a thing.
Well, what channels have you been using?
Well, I began by checking with a friend of mine, George Ferguson, a newspaper man in Nashville.
Bo's from Nashville?
He's supposed to have worked there, but George hasn't been able to find anything about him.
Well, your friend surely must have a lot of contacts.
The best. And then I followed through with some other sources. Nothing. Then the police and the local FBI, and they had nothing.
Hmm. Well, at least he doesn't have a record. Bo Baker is a blank wall.
This is very strange, Rena. It's almost as if the man has no past.
I might be able to help you.
How?
Didn't you say that Bo Baker is a friend of Ruby Wright?
Mm-hmm. She's his manager.
I know Ruby Wright.
You think you can get anything out of
him? Might be interesting to try. Believe your reaction.
Did you think I'd be delighted with the prospect of adopting a 10-year-old boy I've never laid eyes on?
Do you feel that way about taking in my sister, Allison?
Well, no, that's your sister, and besides, she's practically an adult.
Well, Justin, we have to take in Gregory with Allison. I mean, that's the condition of the will.
I know. I heard what Barnsworth said. Listen, we'll find a home for your cousin somewhere.
No! Justin, even if we could and still inherit the money, I wouldn't consider it for a minute.
Why not?
Gregory and Allison have been raised as brother and sister. I mean, they've gone through a terrible shock. I wouldn't consider separating them for a minute.
Ashley, I don't want the boy.
Then we won't get the $40 million.
I don't care about the money.
What?
You heard me.
Justin, we can take my money and save Marshall Oil.
Not with your money.
It's our money, Justin.
No, you're all right the first time.
The first time?
Yes, when you referred to it as your money.
Oh, I didn't mean that. Oh, what's mine is yours, sweetheart.
I'm not going to take money from a woman, even if she is my wife.
I cannot believe your ego.
I have my pride.
False pride.
Call it what you like.
You're going to let your company go down the drain because of your pride?
I will raise the money for Ace High by myself.
Justin, you're talking about taking out a loan.
That's right.
At 28%.
Whatever it takes.
Justin, this is crazy. Absolutely
Ashley,
crazy.
Ashley, you invest your money in Marshall Oil. But this is my company. I'm going to save it, not you. Ashley, save your breath. I have made up my mind. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a lot of work to do if I'm going to get the money for this company.
It's quite not, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's still a little early, you know.
Oh, here's somebody I know. Hi, Brett.
Well, hi, Lurleen.
Let me buy you a drink.
Okay.
Oh, Roy, this is Brett Wheeler.
Hi, Brett.
Hi.
Can I get you something?
What are you having, Lurleen?
Ginger ale on the rocks.
I'll have the same thing.
You got it.
Well, Miss Kate will be happy to hear you're not a lush.
Did she send you here to check up on me?
Sure. But she calls it, seeing how you're doing.
I hope she isn't too worried about me. I've called her every day since I left the ranch.
She cares about you, Lurleen.
I care about Miss Kate, too. She's been wonderful to me.
I don't think Kate is happy unless she's got something to worry about.
Well, you can tell her that the country mouse is making out just fine in the city.
Does that mean you have a job?
Not exactly, but sort of.
And that means?
And my friend Ruby Wright, she and I are going to be partners.
Oh, in what?
She said that we shouldn't talk about it until things are settled. She said it's bad luck.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you. So, this is the coop, huh?
Oh, that's right. You've never been here. Well, what do you think of the place?
It's hard to tell. I just got here.
You sure do meet a lot of interesting people here.
I bet you do. One of them just walked in.
Ashley?
What?
What's wrong with Justin? I just saw him out in the hall. He's in a terrible mood.
Let's just hope it passes.
Well, I hope it's not bad news from Savannah.
Well, you know, most people wouldn't consider it bad news. I've just inherited $40 million.
You're kidding.
No.
Ashley, that's fantastic. But then what's Justin upset about? He should be overjoyed. Now he can save the company.
Well, that's what I thought.
Well, what's the problem? Is the money tied up?
No. He just refuses to use any of it. He's going to take out a loan.
At 28%? He's crazy.
Well, that's what I told him. It's his pride.
You're married now, Ashley. What's yours should be his.
I've told him that, too.
You know what? You are suddenly a very, very rich woman.
Very suddenly. We're also very suddenly parents. We're taking over guardianship of my sister, Allison. We're legally adopting my cousin, Gregory. If we don't get the money.
The kids he objects to?
Yeah, he seems to object to Gregory coming to live with us.
He can't object to the money.
Huh. Oh, yes, he can. He already has.
Justin has to be the one to wear the pants in the family?
You got it.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I'm going to have to try to get somebody else to talk to him. He won't listen to me.
Paige?
Yeah. Yeah, maybe Paige can talk some sense into him. I'm going to go on home now, okay?
Good night. Ashley. The money. I'm really happy for you. I hope everything else works out. I mean that.
Thanks.
Hi, Decker.
Hi, Ricky.
Hi, Lurline. So, how's the world of rocks, geologist? Fascinating as ever, I hope.
Yeah, I can dig it.
May I have a beer, Roy?
This is Brett's first time at the coop.
Oh, you come to see how the other folks live, huh?
I'm not a snob. I just came by to see how Lurline's doing.
We're taking real good care of Lurline, right, honey?
Right.
Here you go, baby. Thank you, Roy.
Hey, Roy. Give me one of them.
Sure thing.
I don't believe you've met my friend, Brett Wheeler.
No, I don't think I've had the pleasure.
This is Ruby Rock.
Nice to meet you, Ruby. You wouldn't by any chance be related to Lacey Wheeler now, would you? She's my sister.
Is that right?
Oh, birth certificates prove it. Of course, she's a lot younger. Is my gray hair showing?
Here you go, Ruby.
Thanks, Roy. So, Lurline tells me you're partners.
Well, I didn't tell her what we're going to do.
Good. She never discussed it before. It was all settled. And don't walk under ladders, and don't let any black cats cross your path, and if you break a mirror, 7 years, bad luck.
Exactly.
What are you two partners in?
Never mind.
Lurline, would you do me a favor?
Sure, what?
Go out back and check out, see if Wang's got everything all set for tonight, okay?
Okay.
Thanks, honey. So you're Lacey's sister.
What about you? Everything nice, I hope. Not everything.
You speak your mind, don't you?
Why not? How is the dear girl? My sister?
Mm-hmm.
She's still in Australia? Yes, and she's having a wonderful time.
Great.
Maybe she'll stay. I don't think so. What a shame she'll have to cut her vacation short. It's not a vacation.
Why did Lacey go to Australia? I never really understood.
Well, she went there to convince my brother Mark to come back here with her.
To Houston?
Yes. The Wheelers just keep on coming, don't they? There's safety in numbers.
How many are there?
An army. We just keep coming and coming. We'll have to dig foxholes. There's no way to duck us. I think I'll go grab the table before Joe starts.
Mind if I join you?
I wouldn't mind at all, Ricky. It's interesting meeting you, Ruby.
Boy, I'm glad I caught you in.
Oh, hi, Ashley.
Oh, I'm just going over my accounts. If it weren't for the money, I would just hate Christmas. Money. Can I have a minute?
Oh, sure.
Definitely. This can wait. I really appreciate it.
What is it, honey?
Something about the will upset you?
$40 million.
$40 million?
Ashley! That's wonderful!
You're not going to tell me that Justin's upset.
He is.
Why?
Well, the will stipulates that we have to take custody of my sister Allison and, my cousin Gregory.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Ask Justin.
What is his problem, Ashley?
Well, it seems that, he doesn't want to adopt, my Aunt Hildy's son.
I don't understand.
It's obvious. Think about it.
Oh. Actually, it wasn't that difficult. Justin wants his own son. And he probably resents your cousin because he doesn't have his own son. I'm sure that's it. And to top it all, he refuses to take any of my money to help save the company. That's insane. Because it's your money.
Exactly.
He has to be a big shot. He has to be the one to do it on his own with his own money.
I can't believe his ego.
No, actually, he is a male chauvinist. You are a woman. You are his wife. That's the problem.
Well, he's not going to listen to me. Someone has to talk to him.
Could that someone be me?
Would you?
Where is he?
If you look right now, he's still in his office.
Okay, I'll talk to him.
Oh, Paige,
thank you. Into that man's head.
Juanita, you look gorgeous.
Well, it's the outfit, Billy Joe. Paige gave it to me as a present.
Yeah, well, that outfit ain't too bad either.
Billy Joe,
What? Oh, well, what do you think?
Well, it's nice, but why are all the lights turned off?
Oh, wait a minute, I forgot that one. Hold on. Now, I want you to sit right down here. Whoops. Sit right down here in the
lounge,
okay? Okay. I'm with her. Right down here.
Don't let the baby go out to eat.
Anita, do you remember what I fixed for you the last time we had dinner?
No, can't say I do.
Well, I'll give you a hint then. It was before the baby was born.
How long before?
It was when you took it back the last time. Fixing you Mexican dinner again.
Oh, yeah, I remember. The end lattice caught fire in the oven, and then the neighbors called the fire department and came over. Oh,
that's right, I forgot. Well, almost three detailed that one, you know. I even got the flowers, the same kind of flowers I bought the last time.
Yeah, you did.
Did you notice?
It all looks lovely.
You really mean that?
Of course I do, but I didn't get all dressed up to have dinner here.
It's great to have you back home again. Hey, this is going to be one that we're never going to get as long as we live. What's your problem?
What kind of problem could I possibly have? Calling him to 40 million big bucks.
I know about that. I just spoke with
him. 40 million bucks. She came running to you?
She did, Tom, running to me. She's concerned about you.
Justin, why are you acting something like this.
I really don't understand, do you?
No, I guess I don't.
Marshall Oil is my company. It's my baby, babe. Marshall Oil is me. That means if there's trouble, it's me that bails it out, not my wife.
But that doesn't mean that you can't let her help you.
I won't have Ashley calling the shots.
Oh, she wouldn't do that.
Oh, no? Oh, no, it'd be her money. I'm not going to sleep. I am not going to rest until I have earned my fortune. On my own and in my own.
You're acting like a stubborn mule, Jeff. Use her money to save Marshall Oil.
I will not. My company win or lose.
Okay. Company's gonna go under. You'll let her help you. What are you gonna do then?
I don't know yet.
Don't let pride blind you, Joss.
False pride. Was it actually?
Well, she's right, Big Shot. I just want you to think about this one carefully.
You really don't know how I feel, do you?
Yes, I do. I just think you're wrong. Look, Freddie, I don't really care what you think. This is Billy Joe's first show. I want to make sure everything's ready to roll. Don't just stand there and shrug your shoulders, man. Go do something about it.
You're a real slave driver there, Ruby.
I gotta be if I want things done right around here.
I don't know what you're so worried about. You got a good staff.
Yeah, well, they don't have the stake in this that I do.
Come on, Ruby, relax. Everything's gonna be just fine. Where's Billy Joe? Is he all excited about the show?
Right now, he's too mad to be excited.
What's he mad about?
Last night, he had a dinner date with Nita.
Yeah, but he's been planning that for months.
Yeah, well, it didn't work out the way he planned.
Ruby, give me something from wardrobe. Look at that. The line's coming out of this stupid jacket I'm supposed to wear.
All right, Billy.
Wardrobe!
I don't know, Ricky. I just hope we make it through the show. Freddie, can you bring the boom down? Can you hear me? Freddie? Is this thing open? Before we finish up the dishes in there, is there anything else that you want?
No, thank you.
Not even a piece of apple pie?
Look, if I eat any more, I'll start waddling.
Well, you do have to keep your strength up.
You forget I'm used to being out in the field. The stomach of mine is not accustomed to all the attention it's getting around here.
No, but you've been hurt.
Yes, you have. And I still think you should see a doctor.
Well, I think I'm doing very fine without a doctor. Don't you, Junie?
Well, are you doing fine enough to move over to Rena's cabin?
But, Kate, there's no reason to rush things.
Oh, he seems to be perfectly capable of getting around.
Just barely. There's no reason why we can't give him at least a few more days so he can handle things on his own.
Kate, I think she's right. I think I'm going to have to impose for a little while longer.
Well, I was only asking.
Would you like me to bring you the newspaper?
No, thank you, Jenny. Look, I'm all played out.
I'm not surprised at that. You've been pushing yourself pretty hard.
Well, if you ladies will excuse me, I'm going to head on upstairs. Come on, there you go again. My angel of mercies, always fussing over me.
I am not fussing. Listen, I'm going to Marshall Belge in a little while. If there's anything you need, let me know.
Okay, Jenny, I will.
Try being a little more patient with Miles. Having here a couple more days isn't going to hurt us.
Well, I suppose not. What did Ryan say when you talked to him? What did he suggest?
About what?
About Professor Rehnquist. When you told him, when you talked to him, what did he say we should do about him?
I didn't tell Ryan about Miles.
Let me put it this way to you, Mr. Frazee. I know you're not directly involved with the oil business, but, well, this is the age of diversification. Now, what we're asking here is just a minimal investment. I say somewhere in the neighborhood of 200,000. Oh, yes, yes. Oh, no, 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 I understand perfectly. Yes, yes. But if you should change your mind, Mr. Frazee, you know where to reach me. Yeah. And be sure and say hello to that lovely wife of yours. Yes. Bye. Bye-bye. I'm so tired of being polite.
Justin.
What?
We've avoided it long enough. We're going to have to talk.
Esther, can't you see that I am busy?
My sister Allison and my cousin Gregory are going to be here in a few hours.
Handle it. It's your family. It's your responsibility.
No, Justin, you heard Mr. Farnsworth. It's our responsibility. Yours and mine.
All right, it's our responsibility. What do you want me to do about it?
I want you to look at me. I need you to look at me and tell me honestly, Justin, whether you're going to be able to deal with this or not.
Surprise party for Mr. Wheeler's birthday tonight.
How can it be a surprise party when Mr. Wheeler already knows about it?
He doesn't know who's coming.
Oh.
Did you get the car fixed?
Of course I got it fixed. I drove Mr. Wheeler to work, didn't I?
Yeah, you're pretty smart, but I don't think you know very much about cars.
I never said I did.
Yeah, well, I don't think you ought to tinker with that engine anymore because Mr. Wheeler was pretty unhappy about having to take a taxi cab to work yesterday.
I explained it to him. It's all right.
You're pretty smart, like I said. Not very. I got this for you. It's cut out of a magazine. It's a little coupon. He's supposed to fill this out. It's a correspondence program to be an auto mechanic.
Mm.
You can say thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, here, let me take some of
thank
this
you. Yeah. What are you doing with all these books?
Whoops.
Research. Notes on Shoshonian ethnography, Hopi and Zuni ceremonialism. These aren't about rocks, these are about Indians.
That's right.
Well, why are you reading about Indians?
I need some information for a friend. But, you know, I haven't had any luck. I've been to the library. I spent all morning with these books. Struck out.
Hmm. Do you need any help getting ready for this party tonight?
I don't think so, Vivian. No, I'm all set. Here, give me those. I gotta take them back to the library.
There you go.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Good
trip. I like Brett, but I don't think I'm ever going to understand about geology. What do rocks have to do with Indians?
Haven't you heard of the Rocky Indians? Those books were on linguistics.
Is that a tribe?
It's a science of languages, and most of those books were on various Indian dialects. Hey, you know, I think I've come up with an idea of how to make things up for Mr. Wheeler.
What are you doing?
I'm going to call a friend of mine. He's a guy I went to Dartmouth with, and I got a feeling he might just be able to help Brett out with her research.
Okay. I'm willing to try dinner again at the top of the World Club. But, frankly, TJ, I'm still a little worried about you and elevators.
Oh, I don't know. Being stuck on an elevator with you might be kind of fun.
Think so?
Absolutely.
Well, we can discuss this a little more over dinner.
All right.
Have you heard anything about Justin?
Well, not really. We're all still hoping that he'll see the light and use Ashley's money to save the company, but I don't know.
Oh, that ego, TJ.
Well, let's hope Ashley can mellow him out a bit, because if she can't, I'm going to be out of a job. And if that happens, you're going to have to pay for dinner tonight.
He's so stubborn.
I know it. He's still planning on borrowing money at 28% interest. I told him he might as well write the company off if he does that, but he was in no mood to listen, so.
You know, last night I really thought he might come around, but I guess not. And Ashley, poor Ashley, she's so upset. He won't have anything to do with Aunt Hildy's little boy.
Well, he's had a lot that's come down on him lately.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, look, I've done all I can. Now all we can do is sit and wait. But come on. Let's forget about all this and go out and kick up our heels a little bit tonight, okay?
Okay.
How about if I zoom by your hotel and pick you up about 7:30?
Okay, why don't you zoom by and we'll zoom out.
All right, good. I'll see you then.
Okay.
Actually, don't put me in a corner.
Sweetheart, you're already in a corner. Your back's against the wall. Gregory and Allison are going to be here in less than 2 hours, and Ace High is going to be gone tomorrow afternoon unless you do something.
I have been doing something. I've been calling everybody in this city that has any money.
Yes, I know. And they've all said no. Justin, if you want to save Marshall Oil, you're going to have to swallow your pride. You're going to have to start being practical.
I know what you mean by being practical. You want me to buy myself into solvency with your money.
No, I don't mean that at all.
Actually, there's something you got to understand about me. Either I save Marshall Oil on my own, or it's not worth saving. I don't want your legacy.
Justin, Marshall Oil is your dream. I understand that. I'm not trying to buy your dream with Aunt Hildy's money.
Good.
I have a plan, though.
And what kind of plan?
A way that you can fight off Miss Rena, save Marshall Oil using Aunt Hildy's money.
What are you talking about?
Collateral. You can't secure a loan for less than 28%. Justin, that'll sink this company.
What's the alternative?
Use Aunt Hildy's money.
No.
It's yours by marital right. Use it as collateral. Any bank in this country will give you a loan with that kind of collateral. You take the loan, you pay it back.
You won't try to repay the loan?
Absolutely not. It'd be totally your responsibility.
I won't have to ask for a penny of your money.
Not a penny.
Once I got this Ace High chain started, I'd pay off that loan in no time.
Yes. And see, you're not paying me. You're paying the bank.
Okay. I'll do it. But I won't take a penny of your money. You understand that?
Of course I understand. Yeah. Understood. Now, there's still the other problem. Allison and Gregory. Justin. They're my family. I want them. I want to take care of them. Both of them.
It's not quite the family I had in mind. I understand. We'll make the best of it.
Oh, I love you.
You know, I think we ought to have a party. We'll welcome the children. And we'll celebrate the saving of Marshall Oil all at the same time, huh?
I think that sounds wonderful.
Come here.
Just remember where we were. Yes. Oh. Well, of course. Put her on. Allison, where are you?
At the Houston airport.
Well... you're not due in for 2 more hours.
Well, Gregory and I took an earlier flight.
Well, maybe you knew I was planning on meeting you there.
Well, don't worry about it. I've already hired a limo to bring us
home. Allison, are you sure?
Ashley, I am a big girl now. I can handle this. See you later.
Why didn't you tell Ryan about Mr. Rehnquist?
I didn't know exactly what to tell him.
The truth. I just don't like all this mystery.
There is no mystery.
Well, but why didn't you just tell him that we had a storm and you rescued a man who had an accident?
Well, I didn't want to do all that explaining.
Well, you're going to have a lot more explaining to do when he finds out that you've been keeping secrets.
Kate, Ryan's got a lot on his mind right now. He's right in the middle of very delicate... negotiations. I just didn't want to bother him with anything this trivial.
Is it trivial?
Yes. And I don't like what you're implying. Besides, Ryan would probably tell Grant about it, and Miles doesn't want that.
I think it's so strange that you're so concerned about what Mr. Rehnquist wants and doesn't want.
Kate, why do we have to argue about this?
Well, we won't. as soon as that man moves out of here.
I'll get it. Rita!
Hi, Vinny.
Hi. What are you doing here at this hour?
Oh, I was over at the Summerhays Ranch discussing an oil lease. It's not very far, you know, so I'm here. And I've got an invitation for you both.
What sort of invitation?
I'm having a birthday party for Grant tonight at the Top of the World Club. I'd like both of you to come.
Well, that's wonderful. You know, Grant was so helpful in saving the ranch. I'd like to see him and help him celebrate.
What about you, Jenny?
I don't know. What's wrong?
Nothing. It's just that I don't think it's a good idea for me to leave Miles alone here.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I have some things to finish in the kitchen. Whatever Jenny decides, you can count on me.
8 o'clock. See ya, huh?
Mm-hmm. I'll be there.
Bye, Jenny.
Bye.
Kate's needling is really getting to me.
What?
Oh, she thinks I'm too concerned about Miles, and it's really none of her business.
Oh, honey, she just doesn't like the idea of having a strange man at the ranch. You know how she is. Sure you won't come?
I better not. Steve's spending the night at the Colemans, and I don't think Miles really can get along on his own right now. Besides
what?
Well, I guess I'm being foolish, but I'm not so sure that Miles is safe.
What do you mean?
Well, everything points that he's in some sort of trouble, and I don't want to take any chances.
Oh, now, Ginny. Ginny, you be careful.
Oh, I will.
No, I mean it. I don't care what kind of promises you've made to Miles. If you sense that there's any danger, you call for help.
I will. I promise.
Oh, I got to get back to the office, honey. Listen, are you sure you're not over your head in this?
Honey, I'm just fine. And thanks again for the invitation.
If you change your mind, you can always come.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Look at this, Nita, will you? This is part of that new Caswell LaRoche line. I like the design, but I'm just worried about the material. I'm afraid it's just not going to be suitable for Texas climate. What do you think?
What? Oh, I'm sorry, Paige. What did you say?
Nita, you have been somewhere else all day. We should come back. Does this have anything to do with your dinner date with Billy Joe last night?
Oh, it's all my fault. I should have known it wasn't going to work out.
Why? What happened?
Well, I went over to Billy Joe's.
Yeah?
He had the candles lit and soft music playing, champagne, a whole bit.
Sounds romantic.
Oh, it was. But I'm not ready for that. And I was wearing that outfit you gave me?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, I thought we were going out, but Billy Joe had a home-cooked meal ready for me.
Ooh. Did you know that his new show starts this afternoon?
Yeah, and that's what's got me worried.
Why?
Well, the whole night was a disaster. He wanted romance. I didn't. I wanted to go out. He didn't. He burned the dinner. Everything went wrong. He's upset. I let him on, and it's all my fault.
Oh, Nita, you're just being hard on yourself.
After he burned the dinner, the evening went from awful to worse. We ended up at this little Chinese restaurant, and neither of us could think of a thing to say to each other. If I was down in the dumps, Billy Joe was in the pits.
Honey, I'm sure that he's had plenty of time to get over it.
Oh, wait a minute. You don't know Billy Joe. He broods. He's a champion brooder. I'm afraid it'll show on the talk show.
Well, call him.
Yeah, I want to, but if I start talking to him about last night, he's going to ask me out again on another date, and then we're right back to where we started from.
Don't mention last night. Just call and wish him good luck.
He probably won't even accept my phone call.
Oh, no. I think he'll accept your phone call.
Yeah, maybe. Okay. I'm gonna do it.
Do it, Nita. I'm gonna get lost. Just do it, okay?
Ashley, will you please calm down?
I can't believe that Allison did this.
They're going to be all right.
Well, Justin, they ordered a limousine that should have been here by now.
Well, they could have run into traffic.
Hi.
Gregory. Well, look at you.
Who's he?
Oh, that's your cousin, Justin. Justin, this is Gregory.
Hello, Greg.
My name's Gregory. Nobody ever calls me Greg.
Oh.
Do you own this building?
No, not yet.
Where's Allison?
She's probably still in the elevator. I pushed all the buttons when we got on. But I got bored stopping at every floor. So I got off and took another car. Allison stayed on with the luggage. This is a neat office.
Thanks.
What are these buttons
doing? Don't touch those, please.
Hi, everybody. Allison! Oh, are you all right? Except for aging in the elevator, I'm fine.
Oh, yeah, Gregory, tell me about that.
It's the first time I've heard an elevator song all the way through.
Well, Ashley, aren't you going to make an introduction?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Right.
You're Justin, hi. I'm Allison.
Well, hello, Allison. It's very nice to meet you.
I've heard so many wonderful things about you from Ashley.
I had no idea you were such an attractive young lady.
Thank you. Allison, where's the luggage? In the outer office.
Oh.
Why did you change your flight? We got bored waiting.
Well, you knew I wanted to come meet you.
Well, we're here. That's what matters. Isn't that right, Justin?
Oh, absolutely.
Gregory, would you bring me my coat, please? I need to get y'all on back to the hotel.
Well, hold the phone here. I got some plans.
What?
Well, Billy Joe is doing his television show this afternoon. I think we should go down there and lend him some support.
Oh.
Billy Joe Wright, he's a spokesman for my chain of Ace High gas stations. Another one of my companies, Allison.
Well, I think that sounds like a good idea.
Well, it's about time we should do that. What do you say, Gregory? You want to see a TV station?
Yeah, that sounds neat.
Good, then we'll be a foursome.
Wonderful.
I'd rather not go. It doesn't sound too thrilling watching a local TV show. You mind if I stay here?
Allison.
I'd love to have you come, Allison.
Okay, suit yourself. We'll be back in a little while, and I'm going to take you over to the hotel so you can get ready for tonight.
Why, what's tonight?
Justin is going to take us all out to celebrate you coming to Houston. Unless, of course, you don't think that that's thrilling enough.
I would love to come.
Great. Great.
Are you guys coming or what?
We're on our way, Shorty. Just let me get my hat.
See you later.
Look, Freddie, I know you checked it, but I really think something's out of focus over there because we're getting a big lightning spill on that panel right there. Would you be a sweetheart and look into it for me?
Okay, I'll check it out with Alan, and if he says it's wrong, we'll fix it.
Thanks, darling.
Ruby, I'm gonna head on over to the other studio.
Why? Hey, don't put that there. Get it off. Way off.
Look, if Billy Joe is in a bad mood, then he's not gonna want any strangers hanging around on the set.
You're no stranger.
Ruby, you seem to forget that Billy Joe and I have not always been friends.
Ricky, do me a favor and stick around, okay?
Well, sure, but I don't think...
The way Billy Joe's been asking, I don't know what's gonna happen. Well, I might even need you to fill in for him.
No way.
You should see the way he's carrying on in his dressing room.
It's just nerves.
He's acting like a mad dog on a short leash. He's yelling at everybody inside.
Yeah, well, don't look now, but here comes your mad dog, and it looks to me like he's just been cured.
You know, that sewing needle, yours has saved the day. Thank you, Ken, Don. Really.
Hi, Rick, yo, buddy. Good to see you.
Hey,
how
Billy
you doing?
Joe, all right.
You're going to stay for the show, aren't you?
Well, I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Well, good, good. I think we're going to start out real good. I'll tell you what. Do you know what our manager here has lined up for us here on the talent department?
Billy Joe, are you on something?
No, I'm fine.
Well, what happened to that crazy man back there who was yelling and screaming at anybody who passed by his door?
Oh, that crazy man. Oh, yeah, well, he just got himself a phone call from the lady he loves.
Nita called you?
Mm-hmm. You better believe it, little sister. Everything's going to be just fine.
Uh-oh.
You know, I've been thinking of a new opening for the show, though. Let me show you. Instead of me sitting down over here at the opening, I want to be standing up right... Excuse me. Excuse me, guys. Yo, guys. We're working here, okay? Can we give us a little space? Thank you.
Vivian, would you come here for a minute, please?
I told you before, a good sir.
I'd like you to meet Dan Phillips. I went to Dartmouth with Dan. Dan's a full-blooded Hopi Indian.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
You're here just... It's good.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. You're here to see... Who is he here to see?
I think he can help Brad. Excuse me, I was looking for Justin.
Oh, he's out. As a matter of fact, everybody's out. Except me. You're TJ, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right. How'd you know?
Ashley's told me all about you.
Oh, you must be Ashley's little sister.
Hey, if we're gonna be friends, you better forget that little sister stuff. Want to take me to lunch?
I'd love to, but I have an appointment.
Well, don't say I didn't ask.
You put it right on the line, don't you?
That's right. Deal straight, stay straight. Ashley knew you in college, didn't she?
Yeah, that's right. She tell you that?
Yeah. She make a big thing out of it. What were you like then?
Arrogant and unsure.
Sounds like half the men I've ever met.
Well, now that you're in Houston, maybe we can change your luck.
Oh? Tell me more. Is Houston absolutely packed with fascinating men? Have I reached the end of the rainbow?
I think you're the kind of a woman who creates the end of a rainbow.
Is that a come on or a tease?
The truth.
Do you like Ashley?
Yes, very much.
Why do you get so nervous every time I bring her up?
Do I?
Sure. It's like a horn blows behind you or something. Maybe it's because she's dangerous.
Is she?
Oh, I've always thought so. She's ambitious. Going for the top with no holds barred.
Is that bad?
No, I love it. But we'll probably clash.
I wouldn't bet against it.
World oil. I love it. Maybe they'll give me a job.
Watch out. That's the enemy camp.
Why, what's going on? A war or something?
I'm close to it.
Maybe I'll be a spy. Yeah, I like that. I think I'll go right over.
Off limits. I don't advise it.
Off limits. We'll see about that.
I want to thank you all out there for being with us on our very first show. And I'm going to be looking forward to seeing you out there tomorrow when our guests will be Abby Van Stram, State Senator Bill Henkel, and of course the Rawhide Twins. It's going to be a good one, and I wouldn't steer you wrong, because I'm Billy Joe Wright. We'll see you all tomorrow. So long.
Show, Billy Joe. Very smooth.
Hey, thank you, Freddie. I mean, you're the guy who held this whole show together for us. Thank you, buddy.
No sweat, Billy Joe. You just keep the talk flowing like that, and it's going to be a piece of cake.
Thank you.
Right, big brother. You were terrific.
Ruby.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. I feel great, too. Where's Ricky?
Oh, well, he stayed as long as he could.
Yeah, well, did he hear my moral for the moment?
Well, he had to go to work, Billy Joe. He's taping the Phil Roberts show over in the next studio.
Oh, well, what'd he say?
He said you're going right to the top.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, I forgot to tell you, we've got some other friends in the studio audience, too.
Oh, yeah, who?
Right behind you.
Oh, hey, Justin, how'd you like the show?
You were fantastic. You're going to make a real fine spokesman for me, Billy Joe.
That's good to hear.
Yeah, well, you've met my wife, Ashley.
Oh, yes, I have. Ashley, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to see you again.
Hi, I'm Gregory Linden.
Oh, hello there, little buddy. Good to see you, too.
Can I see inside the control booth?
No, I don't think so, Gregory, no.
Why not?
Oh, well, you see, Uncle Freddy up there, he's kind of busy right now, but maybe some other time.
When?
Soon.
I'll tell you what, though, why don't you just look around the set here?
The show was wonderful, Billy Joe.
You didn't have any trouble getting in, did you?
No. Oh, no, not at all. And it was great. Show was great.
You know, I think that's awful nice of you to come by and visit me like this.
I wouldn't have missed it. Carried the ball. Remember the ball, you carried the ball, Billy Joe.
Good to hear.
After all, I think you're a very important member of Marshall Oil's future.
Oh, hey, what's happening with the Ace High gas station, Jake?
Yeah.
Ruby, I don't think there's anything to worry about. That's for sure. I wouldn't steer you wrong.
Honest?
But yeah. I think Marshall Oil and Ace High are as good as married. That's why I want to throw this big party tonight at the top of the World Club. Lots of champagne. I want you and Ruby to come along. Lots of champagne to celebrate your new show.
Hey, I'm going
to
be there.
What about you?
I'll be there with bells on now that we got Ace High.
You know, I think it's terrific. Everything's just going wonderful here.
Couldn't be better. All right, tonight, 8 o'clock, top of the World Club. I'll see you then.
Thank you, Justin.
Thank you, Justin.
Bye-bye.
Gregory?
Hey, Greg, come on.
Gregory.
All right, Gregory, come on.
Can I get you some chocolate cake and coffee?
Thank you, no.
I'm sorry I don't have any pemmican.
What?
Pemmican, pemmican. Isn't that what the Indians like to eat?
I'm sure some of my ancestors did, but I'm not even sure what it is.
Oh. You know, you don't sound like an Indian.
I don't?
No. In the movies, the Indians are always, you know...
You don't look French either.
Why would I look French?
Well, in the movies, the maids are almost always,
Oh, yeah. I see what you mean. Do you live on a reservation?
No, I live in a condominium near the university. My mother lived on a reservation.
Couldn't I get you some coffee, some cake, some milk, something?
Thank you, but no.
I'm glad you're back. Come here.
See, we have a guest.
Mr. Phillips. Mr. Dan Phillips. This is Brett Wheeler.
Are you a friend of Vivian's?
Mr. Phillips is an Indian.
No, I'm a friend of John's. He told me you were having a problem, and I thought I might be able to help.
Oh, Kate, you look beautiful. Grant will be very flattered.
He'd be even more flattered if you'd come along with me.
I can't do that.
Why not? Now, you ought to, for Ryan's sake. He and Grant are business associates.
Well, then Grant will understand.
I don't. Oh, Ginny, there's still time for you to change your mind and come along with me. Stop all this nonsense about staying here with Mr. Rehnquist.
It's not nonsense.
Mr. Rehnquist is perfectly capable of taking care of himself.
I don't want to discuss this anymore, Kate.
I think you're being foolish. But it's up to you. If I had my way, that man wouldn't stay in this house.
Well, he's here and he needs me.
All right. We won't say anything more about it. I'm going to the party. Just keep this in mind, Ginny. You're playing with fire.
Am I the fire you're playing with?
No. No, of course not. We were discussing something else.
I don't believe you.
Well, believe whatever you like. I better go get dinner ready.
As you wish.
Excuse me.
So what you're saying is the word high toe pa means nothing to you?
In the sense I can't give you a definition, yes. It's unquestionably an Indian word. It's probably derived from one of the ancient tongues. More than likely, it's part of the Uto-Aztecan family.
Why do you think that?
The consonant structure, for one thing. I'm familiar with native linguistics.
Is there any place I can go to research this word?
there's no dictionary, if that's what you mean. Indian languages and lore and oral tradition handed down from generation to generation.
Well, it sounds like I'm up against a brick wall.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I don't know what the word means, but that doesn't mean we won't be able to find someone who does.
Are you willing to help me?
Possibly. But I'd like to know why you're so interested in finding out about this word.
I'm doing some research for a friend of mine. I can't talk about it. I can't tell you any more than that.
I see. Well, it's been nice meeting you, Miss Wheeler. Sorry I couldn't be of more help.
We're early.
Not really. Is the champagne ready, Ricardo?
Yes, ma'am.
Lovely. I think we'll start with some. Thank you.
Oh, I see you share your father's taste in fine wine.
Mm-hmm. In wine and in friends.
This is very thoughtful of you, Raymond.
Thank you. Very good. I hope you don't mind, but I'm glad we got here early. I wanted to wish you a happy birthday before the others arrived.
Thank you.
That'll be all. Well, here is to a very, very happy birthday. And to the beginning of a long relationship.
Relationship?
Well, I hope.
Nothing I'd like more. Rena, there was something that I did want to discuss with you, but with the press of business, I thought that we could...
Hi!
Oh, hi, Vivi!
I bet you didn't know I'd be here.
I insisted that she come.
Oh, happy birthday, Dad.
Oh, you're not supposed to do this. Thank you.
Here.
Well, neither are you.
I guess I can get you a present if I wanna.
I guess you can. Sit down. Have some champagne.
Oh, I don't know if I should have any champagne. Mrs. Wheeler always says I get silly when I drink.
There's nothing wrong with being silly.
Honest?
Sure, drink it and be silly.
Come on, Vivian, live dangerously.
Oh, all right, I don't know why I shouldn't.
Here you are.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Well, thank you.
Oh. The champagne
tickles your nose. That's what I was going to say.
Well, I must confess that I really didn't want a birthday party, but I thank you for doing it, Rena.
Oh, I'm just glad that Brett told me about it in time.
Oh, so it was you. It wasn't Vivian after all.
Guilty.
Well, I smelled a conspiracy afoot.
Dad, it was a conspiracy of love. We all love you.
Well, for the 50th time, thank you.
I speak for all of us when I say you're welcome.
Happy birthday, Grant.
Thank you.
May I join the party?
You certainly may. We have a special chair reserved for you.
It's so pleasant seeing you here. Where is Penny?
Well, she wasn't feeling well this evening.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, it is.
Well, come on.
She'll be herself soon.
Sit down.
That was a terrific dinner.
Oh, well, anyone can make a steak.
Hey, don't you bet on that. Anyway, I was talking about the company, not the steak.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Your smiling presence was enough. But you didn't keep up your end of the conversation and turn me into a windbag.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I wasn't fishing for an apology. Do I make you uncomfortable?
No.
Well, I hope not. I have a habit of being direct. Are you sure I'm not getting too personal with my questions? I didn't even know why you're answering mine. I never answer yours.
It's all right.
I wish I could tell you more. I just can't. But I do promise you one thing. I am not being hunted by the law.
I know you're not.
Well, I wish Kate understood that, too.
Oh, you've got Kate all wrong. You know, Miles, she really would be wonderful about this if...
If what? If your husband was here? Well, I can understand that you're a beautiful woman. I can see why she would be worried that I may be attracted to you.
You're not the one that Kate's worried about. Well, better finish the dishes.
Jenny.
Yes.
It was a wonderful dinner.
Thank you.
I think we need another toast.
We just had a toast.
Yeah, but that was before Miss Marshall was here.
Oh, thank you, Vivian. I don't drink.
Well, use your water glass.
Vivian, who should we toast to now?
To the Indian.
Iris is right. She really does get silly.
She certainly does.
Friend, there are two reasons that we're here tonight. First of all, we're going to celebrate Grant's birthday, and we're going to celebrate World Oil's acquisition of the Ace High filling stations and the demise of Marshall Oil.
Well, if and when we acquire Ace High stations, it'll be due entirely to your persistence.
Does Mr. Marshall know his company's going to demise?
Well, if he doesn't, he's living in a fool's paradise, darling.
He looks awfully happy to me.
Good evening, Mr. Marshall.
Ricardo?
Your table is ready.
Justin, I think that maybe we shouldn't stay here.
Nonsense. Nonsense. Having Rena and her party over there will just make things a lot more interesting.
Well, thank you, Gregory.
Just think of this as a World Oil reunion.
I wonder who those people are, Justin.
Let it alone, Rena.
I know, but I just can't believe that he actually had the nerve to show up here wearing a big smile. Don't worry, I'll let the fool to his false paradise.
Now, Ricardo, we'll be expecting a couple more people. Would you make the necessary arrangements, please? I really should go over and pay my respects.
Justin.
Later, then.
This is a nice place. Well, I'm glad you approve.
They have hamburgers here?
Gregory, if you can pay for it, you can have anything you want.
Don't encourage him, Justin.
What's wrong with hamburgers?
This isn't a fast food place.
I wonder where that champagne is.
Justin!
Have I got good news for you?
Good news?
Good news! We've had over 200 phone calls to the studio. The show's only been off the air for a couple of hours.
Elliot said he's never seen a more positive response.
Oh, that's wonderful. Why don't you two just come right on over here and join us? We can start this celebration.
How could Justin be celebrating?
It's his birthday, too.
I wonder if maybe
Rena.
He would...
Rena, let it alone.
I'm sorry, you're right. Anyone like more champagne?
Mm-hmm. And you didn't tell me.
It must have slipped my mind.
You got a letter from Miss Wheeler, and you didn't even tell her own sister, Mr. Wheeler.
Yes, I got a letter, but Vivian, I have had an awful lot on my mind.
Well, since it's your birthday, you're forgiven. So what does she say about Mark?
Well, he's still considering my offer.
It's been weeks. How long does it take him to make a decision?
Well, it's not that simple. He's got to uproot himself from Australia and come here to Houston. But Lacey seems to feel that he's going to do it.
Well, he'd better decide soon.
Well, I think it'll be soon. And we can sure use his help. Can't we? Rena.
What?
Rena, will you stop thinking about Justin and Ashley and just enjoy yourself?
How could I enjoy myself when I know that Justin is up to something? There's no reason for them to be celebrating tonight. Not with Marshall Oil about to go under.
Just let it rest.
Not that, don't be hard on her, Grant. But after what Justin's been up to, he bears watching.
I'm going to go over there and see what they're up to.
Sit down, Rena.
What?
Sit.
You've been doing it a long time.
A secret.
Ah, I should have known. Everything about you is a secret.
Yes, my entire life is one big secret.
Do you like it that way?
No, not particularly.
Well, then why can't you...
Remember?
No questions.
It's so frustrating.
I'm sorry, Ginny. That's the way it's just got to be right now.
You're drawing a survey map.
Why would you think that?
Well, because you're a geologist. That's what you're doing. I mean, it wouldn't take a genius to figure out that you're probably surveying this area.
This woman is just too clever for me.
Don't worry. I promise I won't tell a soul.
Do you like to have a look at it?
I thought it was a secret.
Well, since you know what it is already.
That's nice. I think I'll, go make some tea.
Late, Mr. Baker.
I had a little trouble getting here.
I demand punctuality. If this ever happens again, you'll have more than a little trouble.
It won't happen again, Mr. H. I swear it.
I'm sure of it.
So, do you have something? I'm getting kind of itchy with nothing to do.
There is something for you to do.
Great. What?
Miles Rehnquist. You're going to see him tonight.
To go to dinner?
Almost. Come on in.
Okay. Lovely. Look at you. You look fantastic.
Thank you. Just an old designer rag I threw on.
Ah, I see. Yeah.
Would you like a drink before we go?
Sounds great.
Okay. Let me see. Scotch on the rocks, right?
You remembered.
Not a hard one to remember. Here you go, sir.
Thank you.
I don't think I better answer that, TJ.
I think you better. You'll be wondering all night who it was that called.
You're right. I think I better answer that. Hello?
Hey, Justin.
John.
Yeah, come on over here and help us celebrate.
Jess, where are you? I can barely hear you.
Ashley and I, we're over here at the top of the World Club. Come on over here and join us.
Well... I don't know. Just TJ and I were just about to leave for a quiet little dinner over there ourselves.
Well, you can both come on over here and have dinner with us. We'll all celebrate to the success of Martian Oil.
What? Does that mean you got the Ace idea? You got the money? Justin, that's fabulous.
Oh, it's more than fabulous. It's fantastic. You just get your little body on over here.
Now, Just.
I will not take no for an answer.
All right. Okay, we'll be over as soon as we can. Bye. Justin and Ashley are at the top of the world celebrating, and they want us to join them. Do you mind?
Do we have a choice?
I don't think so.
No.
I'm sorry. Did you know that Justin got the Ace High deal?
Yeah. No, he hasn't actually settled it. He's just agreed to use Ashley's inheritance as collateral for a loan. It means the same thing.
Well, I think this deserves a toast, don't you?
Oh, of course.
To Marshall Oil.
I'll toast to that on one condition.
What?
That you'll allow me to make another toast. A more personal one.
Rena, this is my birthday. You did arrange this. Will you please enjoy yourself?
Yes, I'm sorry.
It's all right. Now, what are we going to have?
Well, now,
Paige is on her way. Oh, TJ's coming with her. They were going to have dinner here anyway.
Well, great. The more the merrier.
Who is Paige?
Paige is my sweet, lovable, darling sister.
Who also happens to own one of the most exclusive dress shops in all of the East. Really? Is that where you buy your clothes?
Not yet. Someday.
Someday.
Where's the food?
Be patient.
But I'm hungry.
You'll get it when it's ready. We're here to celebrate. Celebrate, and that calls for a toast. I want to make a toast to Billy Joe and his success today on his television show, and the success he is going to make as my representative of Ace High Gasoline Chain. Here, here.
Here, here.
All right.
Something
to drink.
Here.
No, Justin, you can't have champagne. It's too young.
Then what am I going to drink?
Stop being such a brat.
I tell you what, I'll get the waiter to bring your hamburger, all right? We'll just wait until TJ and Paige get here.
Justin, this is a terrific celebration, buddy.
Well, thank you very much, Joe.
Excuse me just a minute. Hi, Ricky.
Oh, hello, Ruby.
Justin's throwing a big party for Billy Joe. Just thought maybe you might want to join us.
No thanks, Ruby. I've got some friends over here.
See this Rehnquist fella, we don't even know where he is.
We have it narrowed down to an area which includes only a few places. You're going to investigate one of them tonight.
Which one?
The Marshall Ranch. You know where it is?
Oh, I'll find it. Say, why are we looking for this Rehnquist fella anyway?
He has something I want.
What's that?
All in good time, Mr. Baker. Your job is to do as you're told, not to ask a lot of questions.
What do I do if I find this guy on the Marshall Ranch?
I'll tell you. Listen carefully.
In the Orient, the most...
Hello, everybody.
Hi.
Hey, hello, Ricky. Hi, Brett.
Decker.
Looks like a special occasion.
It is. It's Mr. Wheeler's birthday.
Oh, well, congratulations. Happy birthday, Mr. Wheeler.
Why don't you sit down here and join us?
I'd love to. Thank you.
So what are you doing here tonight?
I work here.
Are you going to sing?
Yeah.
Oh, good. I could listen to you for hours.
Oh, thank you, Vivian. That makes me feel really good.
Well, I watch the Phil Roberts show all the time, so I don't miss you. I think you ought to have a show of your own, in fact.
Well, thanks. You know, that just might happen. An offer's been made.
At KBIK?
That's right. Well, nothing definite yet. We're still in the talking stages.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I hope it works out.
So do I. How are you doing, Kate? Any more trouble out at the ranch?
No, everything's fine, Ricky.
Good.
Where did Ruby go? She should be here celebrating with us.
Well, I saw her talking to Ricky Decker a minute ago.
Excuse me. I'll go find out what happened to Ruby.
Oh, boy.
Did you really have to invite those bumpkins to come along with us?
Allison, I'm ashamed of you. I thought Hildy raised you better than that.
Come on, I didn't say it to their faces.
Well, those bumpkins, darling, as you call them, are going to make a lot of money for Marshall Oil.
Oh, really? I would have thought you'd have gone for a different sort of image.
Well, what do you mean?
Allison, keep your nose out of things that aren't your concern.
I was merely offering an opinion. It just surprised me, Justin, using them. Justin's got more class than that. Excuse me.
Where are you going?
The ladies' room.
Don't get lost.
I think you're pretty hard on your sister.
This hamburger has nothing on it. No ketchup, nothing.
How long do we have to put up with this spoiled child?
All I said was that it had no ketchup on it.
Waiter.
Oh, it's beautiful out here.
Isn't it pretty?
I had no idea you had such a view.
You know, I don't want to, but I have a feeling that we better go. They're probably waiting for us.
Well, I suppose.
Sorry if I kind of spoiled the evening by accepting Justin's invitation.
Well, you didn't spoil it. I was planning on having you all to myself, though.
Well, there will be another night, won't there?
You bet there will.
You are pleased that Justin's taken the loan, aren't you, Chi-Chi?
Of course. We'll save Marshall Oil. Now we'll have a chance to become a major oil power.
You really think so?
No, absolutely, if the ASI chain's handled correctly. And I think Justin has a lot of the right ideas.
Well, I hope for Justin's sake that Marshall Oil is a great big success.
Oh, it will be. And it'll partly be because of you.
How do you figure that?
Well, you were the one who talked Justin into using Ashley's inheritance as a collateral for the loan. If you hadn't done that, it would have been bye-bye Marshall Oil. Here, let me help you with the car.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, I have a lot to thank you for.
Oh?
The pleasure of your company. You know, the best part of switching to Marshall Oil was meeting you.
Ruby, what are you doing out here? Justin's been asking about it. We should be in there celebrating.
I kind of lost the celebrating spirit, Billy Joe.
Does it happen to have something to do with Ricky Decker showing up?
He doesn't even look at me anymore. I'm just his manager.
Ruby, you agreed to that.
Oh, no. I was just hoping things could be different.
Ruby, how'd you expect things to be different, huh? I think you gave Ricky enough reason to be upset with you. You lied to him about Bo.
Bo's not around anymore. I just thought maybe we could start over. We could have another chance.
Well, there's still a chance.
No, there's not. Ricky's got his eye on some other person.
Who?
Brett Wheeler. So I guess nothing more is going to happen between Ricky and me.
Ruby, this doesn't sound like you at all.
What do you mean?
Giving up so easily?
Don't worry, Billy Joe. I'm not giving up. Not yet.
Party, aren't you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I thought I saw you with them. Are you a friend of theirs?
Ashley is my sister.
Her sister? Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't even know she had a sister.
I'm Rena Decker. It's very nice meeting you.
Well, how do you do? I'm Allison Linden.
How do you do? You're not from Houston, are you?
No. No, I lived with my Aunt Hildy before she died.
Oh, yes, I was very sorry to hear about that. Am I keeping you from going back to your table?
Not really, no.
Then you have a few minutes?
Sure. Why?
Well, I thought that maybe we could have a little talk. I felt terrible when I heard about your aunt's death. I know it must have been terribly upsetting for you and your sister.
Well, we're doing okay.
I must admit that I was rather surprised to see you all here tonight. You look like you were having a celebration.
Well, it was Justin's way of welcoming us to Houston.
Oh, so you'll be staying here. Mm-hmm. That'll be very comforting for Ashley. What about the little boy? Is he your brother?
No, Gregory is Aunt Hildy's son.
Oh. Well, I think what Justin is doing now is very admirable.
I don't know what you mean.
Having a celebration for you when we all know that he's putting up such a cheerful front.
But I'm sorry, I still don't understand.
Well, with what's happening to his company and all.
I don't know anything about his company.
Hasn't he told you he's going out of business?
Hello, Miss Rena.
Oh, hello, Ash.
I see you've met my little sister.
Yes, I have. She's a charming girl.
You better get on back to the table, doll, and make sure that Gregory's not driving Justin crazy.
Okay, I'll do what I can.
Go on. I'll tell you to.
Okay. Goodbye, Rena.
I'll see you later, Allison.
What do you think you're doing, Rena?
I wasn't doing anything. I was simply offering your sister my condolences.
You call that cross-examination condolences?
Oh, don't be silly, Ashley. It wasn't a cross-examination. In fact, I've been meaning to call you about it myself. I know how hard it must have been for you to hear about your aunt's death, especially with the mix-up that Marshall Oil is in.
I really appreciate your concern, Rena.
Well, I really am concerned, Ashley. In fact, I was telling your sister, I was really surprised to see you all here tonight.
Well, is that why you were questioning her?
I was only trying to help. Ashley, I know what an added burden it's going to be taking care of your sister and your aunt's little boy, so I'd like to try to help you out. You see, World Oil's going to have some openings for secretaries pretty soon. Perhaps you'd like to apply in case you need the extra money.
Well, that's really very kind of you, Rena.
Are you up to something, Ashley?
Well, what makes you say that?
Because you usually don't give in this easily.
You'll find out soon enough.
Like some more tea?
No, thanks. You want to talk about it?
About what?
Well, about this. You didn't seem too pleased with it. Why not?
Good evening, sir. Your private room is ready.
Thank you.
Please follow me.
Hey!
Oh, Justin.
Glad you can make it. Glad you can make it, DJ.
Hello. Thank you, Justin.
I'm sorry it took us so long.
Well, you made it. That's what's important, huh? Yeah.
I'm sorry I ate before you arrived. I was starved.
Gregory's a growing boy.
Well, that's all right, Gregory. I understand that. Justin was just like it when he was growing up. You
first to the table and first to leave.
Paige, don't give away family secrets. Come on, everybody sit down here. Hey, Ricardo's, more champagne. I guess I should introduce Ashley's folks. This grown boy here is Gregory. God bless him. Is Aunt Hildy's son. And this young lady is Allison. This is Ashley's sister. This is Paige, my sister. It's T.J. Canfield. Works for me at Marshall Oil.
T.J. and I have already met.
When?
while you were at the television station.
We had a nice little chat. DJ, you know Ruby? Billy Joe Wright's sister.
Ruby, nice to meet you.
Hello, Ruby.
Hi, Paige. How you doing?
Fine. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Where's Billy Joe? I thought he was part of this celebration.
Oh, he's going to be back in a minute.
Well, we're not going to wait for him this time to make this toast. Here's to Billy Joe and Marshall Orr.
Yeah.
Best team in Texas.
Woo! Yeah.
Oh. Look at them. The traitor and that tramp have joined Justin.
They seem to be having a real good time.
Hockey. May I see you in the other room for a moment?
Oh, the other room, huh?
Yeah.
Sure.
Let's go.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Where are you going?
Secret.
Well, he seems to be getting along
very well.
Ricky's a nice guy.
I wonder what Brett is up to.
Thank you for joining me without making a fuss.
Well, no problem, but what's the big secret?
Will you sing a special song for my dad's birthday?
That's it?
Will you?
Well, depends on the song.
Oh, just sing something slow that they can dance to, Dad and Rena.
Are you trying to get something together between them?
Hey, don't ask a lot of questions. Now, Dad's favorite song is Teach Me Tonight. Do you know that?
Yeah.
Will you do it?
Sure.
Great, thanks.
On one condition.
What condition?
That you go out with me tomorrow night. I got a night off tomorrow, and we'll just go to some real down-home kind of place. You know?
You won't sing the song unless I agree?
What do you say?
Okay, yeah, I'll do it.
Good.
Okay, it's settled. So, really do a job on that song.
I always do.
Hi, cousin, hi. Oh, hi, Mr. Wright.
Well, howdy, how you doing?
Oh, you don't remember me, do you?
No, I guess I don't.
I'm Vivian. I used to work for Mrs. Wheeler.
Oh, yeah, Vivian, well, how you doing, huh?
I'm fine. I'm working for Mr. Wheeler now.
Well, good, good. It's been real nice talking to you, hon.
I saw your show the other day. Today, you were wonderful.
Well, thanks.
And I used to watch you on the Phil Roberts show all the time, too.
Yeah, I really appreciate
that. You did a real good job the way you handle everything. I don't know how you do it.
Well, I'll tell you something. It's really not that hard, darling. Look, Vivian, I got to go. I got some people waiting.
Oh, sure, sure. Oh, there's one more thing, Mr. Wright.
I know, sure,
Tell me where the ladies' room is.
You don't seem pleased with the drawing.
I don't know why. It's just that I felt...
What, guilty?
I have no reason to feel guilty.
I agree with you 100%.
I guess I was a little embarrassed.
Why?
Well, because I know that you were staring at me while I was reading. And...
It's a hobby. I draw people I like. What was that?
I don't know.
Stay there. I'll go take a look.
You're not moving around very well. I'll check.
Stay there.
They're celebrating something.
Kind of looks that way, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Considering she just lost the ace high chain, she's holding up very well.
She doesn't know about it yet.
She doesn't?
Nope, she hasn't been informed.
But she will, when the time is right.
Where's Ricky? Oh, well, he has to get ready to sing.
What was that secret confab out there?
None of your business.
All right. Now respect your privacy.
Oh, come on, lighten up, Dad. It's your birthday.
Oh, Grant, I want to wish you happy birthday again. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Well, you're not leaving.
I had better go. I have to get back to the ranch.
Well, can't you just stay a little longer, Kate?
I better not. I don't like the idea of Ginny being out there with...
Well, you could just call her, and if she's okay, then you don't have to rush off.
Well, all right. But I can't stay very much longer.
Mm-hmm. the matter with Kate? She looks upset.
Oh, I think it's just Ginny not feeling well. You know how Kate worries about people.
I'm sure that's it.
Billy Joe! Well, now the whole Marshall Oil group is back together again.
Hey, Joe, I would like you to meet T.J. Canfield.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
How are you doing?
Fine.
How are you? How'd the show go?
Just perfect.
Good.
And all because I got a certain phone call from a certain young lady.
Good. I was hoping she'd call.
He'd have called me just before the show, and the rest of my day's been shining straight through.
Billy Joe, you missed the first toast. Now we have to start all over again.
All right.
Let's take your slow down.
No, Donna, we're celebrating tonight. Billy Joe Wright and Marshall Oil.
Yeah.
Best team in Texas.
All right.
Long may they reign.
All right. I'll drink to that.
Me too. Billy Joe's going to make Ace High the most popular guest in the whole Southwest.
Yeah.
That's the way I like to hear you talk.
Well, I'll be right back.
Where are you going now, Paige?
Powder room.
Oh, I think I'll go with you.
You just got back, Ashley.
Well, I just want to look pretty for you.
I'll be right back.
I wish people settled down, stop jumping up and down like a bunch of yo-yos.
That is a big place. I never did find the ladies' room, but I ran into Billy Joe Wright. He is just as cute in person as he is on television.
Yes, too bad he's joined the enemy camp.
That was a purely business decision.
I knew that. I'm not blaming Billy Joe. It's his sister Ruby.
You don't understand what they've got to laugh about.
Oh, Ashley. Justin seems so happy tonight.
Oh, well. Things are starting to turn out right for him.
Yeah. I'm just relieved that he's decided to use that money as collateral.
Oh, Paige. Yes, and I have you to thank for that.
Aw.
No, really, I think you talking to him really did a lot of good.
Well, my pleasure. But I think you had a lot more to do with that decision than I did.
Well, whoever did it, Ace High now belongs to Marshall Oil.
And I bet you can't wait to see Rena's face when she finds out, can you?
Oh, that's going to be the sweetest revenge. She has been so nasty to me. You know, I saw her in the powder room earlier tonight. I started to say something to her then. But I didn't. I want to wait till just the right time, when she's really flying high, before I shoot her down. She's going to be so embarrassed in front of Mr. Grant Wheeler.
Isn't that kind of stooping to Rena's tactics?
Yeah. And I love it.
I feel great.
Oh, Ashley, you little devil, you.
Is everything all right up there?
I think so, but stay there.
Hello, Marshall Ranch.
Ginny, it's Kate.
Yes, Kate.
I wanted to call. I didn't feel right about leaving you there alone.
Oh, Kate, I'm fine, really. Are you having a good time? Grant, my best wishes. I've got to go, Kate. Something's burning. Goodbye. Miles? Are you all right?
She says she is, but I'm worried.
Why?
I don't trust that Rehnquist man.
Would it ease your mind at all if I hadn't checked out?
But how could you do that, Rena? You promised Ginny and Brett that you wouldn't tell anyone where he was.
Well, I don't have to tell anyone where he is.
I'm with you, Kate. I'm concerned about him, too. I'm going to have the professor checked out tomorrow. Oh,
thank you, Rena. That'll ease my mind.
The minute I know anything, I'll tell you something. Now, you get back in there, and I'll see you in a minute.
All right.
I hope this is the last trip somebody will be making to the powder room. This has been the most disjointed celebration. Grandma! Grandma! Well.
Hello, Justin.
Why don't you join us here? We'll have a drink with us. Join our celebration.
I don't think I care to join you, Justin.
I'm sorry to hear that, Grandma. I thought maybe we could be close again.
It's been too long since we've been close, Justin. I doubt that we ever will be again.
Who is that old lady?
That was my grandmother.
Doesn't she like you?
Gregory, please be quiet.
Grandmas give you kisses and hugs. She just walked away. Didn't even smile.
That's a long time to work in one place.
But before I came here, I worked for 25 years in one of the best hotels in Houston.
Have you always worked in the ladies' room?
Oh, no. Made my start as a maid.
That's what I do.
Maids must be earning a lot more these days than they did when I was a maid. I never could have afforded to come to a place like this.
Oh, no, I couldn't afford to come to a place like this. It's Mr. Wheeler's birthday. He and his daughter invited me to come with.
Oh, well, he must be pretty nice.
He's wonderful.
You can thank your lucky stars. There are not many nice people out there to work for.
I've always worked for nice people.
You're luckier than most. They only knew the things we could say about them.
What do you mean?
Everything we see and hear about their personal lives. Like right here, women come in here all the time and talk about things you wouldn't believe.
Really?
But they talk like I wasn't even there, like I was a piece of furniture. Take tonight, for instance. That Mrs. Decker came in here with another lady, a Mrs. Marshall, I think. They were acting all sweetness and friendly-like. But then a little while later, Mrs. Marshall came in with somebody else. And she was telling her she couldn't wait to shoot Mrs. Decker down.
She had a gun?
Oh, no, nothing like that. She was just telling her something about gas stations and what good shape her company was in. They seemed to think it would upset Mrs. Decker.
It would upset her very much. I gotta go find Mrs. Decker.
But do you know her?
Oh, she's a friend of Mr. Wheeler's.
Oh, hey, you don't have to give me no tip. We maids gotta stick together, don't we?
Oh, Mabel. Thank you.
No mention it.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Top of the World Club. I would like to start off the set this evening by dedicating a song to a gentleman. His name is Grant Wheeler. He's the chairman of the board of World Oil Corporation, and he's celebrating a birthday tonight. Happy birthday, Grant. And I'd like to invite any of you who'd like to dance to get on up here and dance, please. You say I've got a lot to learn. Well, don't think I'm trying not to learn. Since this is.
What do you say? Would you like to take a chance with me out there?
Why not?
Teach me tonight. Starting with the ABC.
Well, let's have a little dance, Don.
Right down to the XYZ of it. Help me solve the mystery of it.
Oh, nuts. Don't you think they make a nice couple?
Yes,
they do.
Teach me tonight.
evening, Rena. Graham, congratulations.
Sky is a black.
Thank you, gentlemen. Oh, say, Graham, would you like to swap partners? I'm sure Ashley would like to wish you a happy birthday. Who do you have?
Just if a shooting star goes by.
Certainly.
In fact, I think you should wear this dress when we meet in Dallas again.
When we meet in Dallas?
Yes. When you come to pay off the bet. You haven't forgotten,
I'll bet. Oh, no, I haven't forgotten. You're just talking awfully big for a loser, aren't you?
I haven't lost anything, babe.
Sure you have. What about the ace high stations? You lost those.
I've got the ace high stations in my pocket.
Oh, come on.
That's right. And there's nothing you can do about it, Rena, but weep.
Nobody's going to give you the kind of money you need, Justin.
They will, if there's $40 million in collateral.
$40 million?
Well, that's what old Aunt Tildy left Ashley. Like I said, I would love you to wear this dress when we meet again. Grant, I think your former partner got you back.
Sky is a blackboard.
Got it.
High above you.
Finish dancing, Grant.
If a shooting star goes by, I'll use that star to write I love you.
Rena, what is this all about?
It's Justin Marshall.
Bound
they've got the eighth high cross.
How do you know?
I know because he just told me they've got the money to pay off the station franchise owners.
Sure, the
teacher's $40 million just to use it as collateral against her loan.
Satisfactory, sir? Yes, thank you, Ricardo. I see Mr. Wheeler is still here.
Yes, sir. He and his bombardier are celebrating his birthday.
Oh. Teach me.
Strange. Mr. Marshall should be here, too.
Tonight.
Good night, Ricardo. Good night, sir.
I gotta go.
It's really going to happen. Marshall Oil is going to be all right.
Did you ever doubt it?
Yeah, I sure did. I really worried for a while that we might go under.
I knew we could put the foolish one out of the fire, and we did. Don't you forget, darling, it was your money that secured the loan.
We did it. That's what matters.
We really surprised Rena at World Oil, didn't we?
Oh, did I ever love watching Miss Rena squirm.
She really did squirm, didn't she?
She sure did. I love seeing her lose it that way. Justin, everything's going to work out for us, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it is. Everything except one thing.
What's that?
Gregory.
What about him?
I don't like him.
Justin, he's a nice boy.
Nice? Do you see the way he acted at the top of the World Club?
Justin, he's just a little boy. It's not exciting to go out to dinner with a bunch of adults.
Ashley, we bored him.
Don't be so hard on him, Justin. I mean, after all the stories that you've told me, the things you did when you were a little boy, I mean, you don't have much room to talk. A boy's a boy.
That's different.
Oh, is that a fact?
I think that you could be a good influence on him.
Ashley, I've been thinking. You know, there must be some other way around all this.
Justin, Aunt Hildy stipulated that you and I raise Gregory.
Why, Ashley? That's the part I just don't understand.
Damn it, Justin. What? No, I'm okay. I'm just in a rotten mood. He is. Oh, terrific. Okay, send him in. Oh. Hey, sorry I snapped at you. Dr. Hensel.
Rena.
Good to see you.
Just look at you, this fancy office. I'm proud of you.
Well, maybe you better reserve your judgment. This job is harder than I thought.
Oh, you'll do fine. You're a very determined young lady.
Thank you for saying that. I needed to hear something good today. I hope you didn't mind my interrupting you at the university.
Oh, it makes for a nice break. Besides, it sounded important.
It might be. Dr. Hensel, I need some information.
On what?
On Dr. Miles Rehnquist.
Never slept this late before.
What do you expect after that lump on your head? Miles, somebody is after you. You could have been killed last night.
I knew it was a bad idea for me to stay here. But you folks in the danger, I didn't want to do that.
We haven't pushed you for any answers. At least I haven't.
Yeah, I've caused problems between you and Kate, haven't I?
That doesn't matter. I want you to tell me what's going on. You owe me that much.
Rehnquist is on the Marshall Ranch, all right?
Good. Very good.
I checked his room real careful. It's not there.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Then he must have it on him.
No, he doesn't.
How do you know that?
When I was looking through his room, he came upstairs. I didn't really have a choice. I had to knock him out. While he was out, I searched his pockets. It wasn't on him.
How could you be so stupid, Baker? You put our entire mission in jeopardy.
How did I do that?
Now he'll know someone's onto him. He'll be even more careful.
Well, it's not in his room, and it's not on him.
It's somewhere on that ranch. Rehnquist won't let it out of his sight. He must have hidden it. I want you back on that ranch.
I don't know where else to look.
Use your imagination, Baker. That's what we're paying you for.
If I do find it, what do I do with Rehnquist?
That's my decision. You'll get it in time.
Okay with me.
Mr. Baker, nothing short of success is acceptable. Do I make myself clear?
Perfectly clear, Mr. H.
I will know your secret, Rehnquist. And when I do, I'll have all the power I ever need.
They party good. You know, you're part of the family.
I only wish Mr. Marshall hadn't upset Mrs. Decker like that.
He did that on purpose, Vivian.
That's terrible. Ruining Mr. Wheeler's party?
Yeah, that was the point.
I'll never understand big business. Somebody's always stabbing somebody else in the back. Why don't they just help each other?
Good question.
Is that Indian gonna... Did he help you?
No, but I'm not giving up. That's my project for the day.
Are you gonna talk to another Indian?
Good morning.
Morning.
What's all this about Indian?
Hey, Dad, did you have a good time last night?
I had a wonderful time, thank you.
You and Rena looked great on the dance floor.
None of that stuff.
You're the handsomest couple off the floor.
It was a nice try, but it didn't work.
What didn't work?
Changing the subject.
What subject?
The subject is Indians. Everybody's talking about Indians.
Oh, who?
You gave a toast to an Indian at my birthday, and John gave me a lecture on Southwestern Indian dialects.
Isn't he smart? He knows about everything.
Except cars. He doesn't know anything about cars.
He's learning. Got a whole bunch of books out of the library.
You ever seen the titles?
The titles all had cars in them.
Yeah, about the history of cars. I don't want him to write a dissertation. I want him to learn how to drive them. And by the way, I know what you did. You just changed subject again.
Yeah, it's no big deal. You know, I've always been interested in Indian lore. Since I'm in Houston, I thought I'd do a little research on some local tribes. I gotta go.
Where are you going?
Marshall Ranch.
Oh, tell Jenny I hope she's feeling better.
What?
Well, Kate said she wasn't feeling well.
Oh, yeah, I'll tell her. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Miss Wheeler sure has a lot of energy.
Yes, she does. But I didn't know that she was interested in Indian lore also.
I know exactly why you want this information on Professor Rehnquist.
You do?
You want him to work for World Oil.
I wouldn't mind if he's as good as I hear he is.
Oh, he's the best. But forget it, Rena. Every oil company in the country has tried to lure him.
Nobody's been successful?
No. Money and position have no appeal for him.
Why does everybody want him?
Well, he knows more about the land and its secrets, and about the Southwest than anybody.
Well, what does he know that's so special?
Everything, Renee. He knows it all. Geology, Indian lore. He knows how to find oil. It's as if he can sniff it under the ground. And he's not about to share that with anyone he thinks is going to damage the environment. Above all else, he loves the land. It's his life, his passion.
You make him sound too good to be true. Are you sure he just doesn't have a terrific press agent?
You really don't know anything about him, do you? No, Rena. He shuns the press. Publicity.
Is he on the level?
Absolutely. Ask any geology student. He's their hero.
So I hear.
He has integrity. And he's willing to fight to the death what he believes in.
You make him sound like a saint.
To some, he is.
You do deserve some answers.
Then you're going to tell me what's going on?
I'll tell you what I can. But not so much that I put you into danger.
Well, anything's better than nothing.
It's all got to do with something I've found. It's something that I've been looking for a long time.
What?
I can't tell you that. That's why I'm trying to get myself back into shape so I can get back out there and find it before somebody else does.
That's all you're going to tell me?
That's all I can tell you.
But why?
People's lives are at stake.
Well, if it's really that dangerous, then why don't you get someone to help you? Maybe the government.
Look, I can't do that.
But
definitely
why not?
Not. There's a lot of people everywhere that would risk killing to get this. Jenny, you've got to understand that I can't let anybody find this.
It's something evil, isn't it?
Let's just say it's something that could make people act very desperately.
Oh, makes me shudder even to talk about it.
Well, then let's not. Ever.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to have to leave here today. I can't put you in any more danger. I'm sorry to have got you involved in this in the first place.
I'm not sorry. Where will you go?
Was Rena serious about her cabin?
She offered it. I'm sure she was serious.
Then I'll go there.
Your Aunt Hilde stipulate that you should raise the boy.
She knew that I would take good care of him.
A lot of other relatives could have handled that.
Other relatives didn't inherit $40 million either, Justin.
Still seems like a crazy whim to me.
Well, I never said that my Aunt Hilde wasn't eccentric.
Justin, the ASI people are waiting for you in the conference room.
Ha! Did you take care of the paperwork?
Sure have. All they need is your signature, and ASI is all yours.
Well, it's going to be a pleasure. Mrs. Marshall, you just wait right here. By the time I get back, you and me, we're going to be the new owners of ASI. Ha!
Something wrong?
What could be wrong?
Well, that's what I'm asking. You seem kind of down.
It's nothing, TJ. Let's just drop it.
He isn't thrilled with his instant family, is he?
It just takes some time getting used to.
Well, I'd probably be a little bit upset myself if I suddenly found out that I'd inherited a 10-year-old boy.
What about Allison?
Allison is a completely different matter altogether. Well, girls are different. Besides, she's older. She reminds me a lot of her older sister.
Still the playboy, aren't you, TJ?
Oh, come on, Ashley. I was just kidding.
Well, I don't want you playing with Paige or Allison. I don't want them to be hurt.
I'm not going to hurt anyone. And I wish you'd stop painting me as a villain.
Then stop acting like one.
I didn't know I was. Well, I guess I'd better go and check on Justin. That's going to be a fine day for him.
You really don't like him very much, do you?
I didn't say that.
You didn't have to.
I'm so glad. Did you get the Jeep unstuck?
We can't budget.
You can't? Grandma tried to start it, but it just sank deeper and deeper into the mud.
We're going to get that thing out of there. We're going to have to tow it.
Mom, can I go see Rusty?
Sure, I guess so, as long as you're home in time for lunch.
So where'd you get that?
Oh, it's the professor's.
Kate, you're not going to go through it.
I'm tempted. I want some answers, Ginny, and he sure isn't talking.
It's wrong, Kate.
What's the matter? You think he might be hiding something?
You won't find anything of any interest in that, Mrs. Marshall.
Oh, well, Rusty found it next to the Jeep.
Be good to get back into my own clothes again.
Well, Ryan's clothes fit you.
Oh, it's not the same thing. They're not mine. Anyway, he may object to me wearing them.
Oh, he won't mind.
You don't know that.
I'll be out of your hair by this afternoon, Mrs. Marshall.
Oh, you're moving on?
Well, at least up to Rena's cabin.
Well, that's fine with me.
Yeah, I kind of thought you'd like that. If you'll excuse me, I'm going to head upstairs. I've got to change.
Kate, why do you treat him like that?
He makes everything seem different around here.
What do you mean?
The ranch isn't the same with him here. He's even changing you, Ginny.
Back here, little lady.
Why?
I want to talk to you.
What about?
Where were you this morning?
I went for a walk. Is there something wrong with that?
Well, you were supposed to go with Gregory on the tour of Houston.
I told you I didn't want to go on any tour.
Well, fine. But you can't just go wandering off like that. You have to tell me where you're going.
I am not a little girl.
Okay, you're not a little girl, but I still worry.
Was Justin worried, too?
I didn't tell him.
Oh, that's a surprise. I thought for sure you'd go running straight to him.
No. He has enough on his mind without having to worry about you, too.
Don't lay that on me. I didn't ask for this.
Allie, I know. We've just got to try real hard, okay?
I just feel so strange here. I really miss my friends in Savannah.
I know. But you have always been popular. Everybody always loves you. You'll make new friends.
Well, doesn't look like I have much of a choice.
Look, would you stay here and pick up Gregory for me? I've got to go run some errands.
How am I supposed to make friends if I spend all my time playing babysitter, huh?
It's not going to be for that long. He's got to go back to school after Christmas.
Well, it can't be soon enough for me.
What about you? When are you going to go to school?
I finished school.
I'm talking about college.
Oh, don't you start in on me. And Hildy was always harping at me to go to college. I don't want to go right now. Maybe later, if everyone stops pushing me.
I'm not pushing. I'm not pushing, okay? Look, I really hate to have to go, but I've got to go run these errands. Will you wait in the reception area for Gregory?
Why can't I stay in here?
Well, I guess there's really no reason. But look, do not bother Justin when he comes in, all right?
All right.
Thank you. I'll see you back at the hotel, okay?
You like it?
That's not what I said. I was just wondering what prompted it.
I just wanted to let you know that I had a great time last night.
So did I. So good to see Justin and Ashley happy again.
Well, they had reason to be. Marshall Oil's got a whole new lease on life.
TJ, can I ask you a favor?
Anything.
Better not say that before you know what I'm going to ask you, though.
Like I said, Paige, anything.
Help Justin. Marshall Oil has got to succeed, TJ.
Of course I will. It's important to me, too. I want to succeed. What was that for?
Oh, I don't know. Thanks. I just want everything to go well for them. For you, too.
No sweat. Okay. With that Ace High chain under his belt, Marshall Oil is off to a great start.
Really think so?
Absolutely. Can I have a cup of coffee?
Sure. How do you take it?
Hello there.
Well, hello there yourself.
Hope you don't mind my sitting at your desk.
Oh, no, why should I mind, darling? You look as pretty as a picture sitting up there.
Thanks.
Yeah, but what are you wasting your time sitting here in this dull old office for?
Ashley says I have to wait here for Gregory.
Oh.
But I would really rather go back to the hotel.
Why don't you do that?
Think I should?
You can do anything you want, darling. That is, anything that's legal.
Thanks a lot, Justin.
For what, darling?
For being so understanding. You're different from Ashley. She still treats me like I'm a child.
Well, that's understandable. You're her baby sister.
Yeah, well, at least my brother-in-law knows that I'm not a child.
No, I can see that.
No, I mean, you understand that when a woman reaches a certain age, she's mature.
Mm.
And everyone knows that girls mature a lot quicker than boys.
Yeah. So I've heard.
I wonder if that's why so many women are attracted to older men. What do you think?
Probably right.
You're so easy to talk to, Justin.
Well, listening's not hard.
Well, I really got to get back to the hotel. Now, you make sure that Gregory gets back okay, won't you?
Don't you worry about a thing, darling.
Thanks. You're an angel.
Finish up the last of my shopping.
I can see.
Christmas. I wanted to know if you had anything that Allison might like.
Oh. That shouldn't be difficult. She seems easy to please.
Ooh. I wish that were true.
Why? Problems?
Well, not if you don't mind fighting.
Oh, that's pretty normal, don't you think, Ashley? Justin and I fought like cats and dogs.
Well, if you think brothers and sisters are bad, try sisters and sisters.
Well, she's kind of going through a rough time, don't you think?
Yeah, I know. She really misses her friends in Savannah.
I'm sure it's not easy for her. But she'll have friends. Probably all boys.
I can hardly wait.
Oh, Ashley, Gregory's adorable.
Well, you'd have a fight with your brother on that one.
Why?
He doesn't like Gregory. He thinks that he's a monster.
Oh, he's just forgotten what it's like to be a little boy, that's all.
That's what I told him.
What did he say to that?
Well, he said that it was different.
Well, actually, he's right. Justin was a terror.
I can just imagine.
A holy terror.
Well, obviously, he doesn't remember it that way, Paige.
Well, maybe I'll have to remind him then.
I wish you would. I'm really worried about how tense it is between the two of them.
Oh, honey, that won't last. Gregory's such a cute little boy. He'll win him over in no time.
I sure hope you're right. Justin's talking about shipping him off to another relative.
Oh, that's just talk, honey. Thanks for last evening. I had a wonderful time.
Oh, I did too.
Oh, did I love seeing Miss Rena fall on her face?
She was really fuming, wasn't she?
I loved every minute of it.
Yeah, and from the looks of it, she really took all the party out of that other table, too. I was going to ask you, do you know Grant's daughter,
Brett?
Yeah, she stopped by here.
She's very unusual. I liked her.
Well, I was impressed with the way she carried herself. Too bad she's on Miss Rena's team.
No, I wouldn't worry about Brett. I think she's one young lady that Rena can't control. Let me see what I have for Allison.
I'll be right back. I'll come with you. She loves red.
Oh, really?
Jenny, did you talk to Ryan today?
He hasn't called.
Well, if he does call, are you going to tell him about Miles?
What's the sense in upsetting Ryan?
If you're going to be honest, Jenny, you're going to have to ask yourself whom you're really worried about upsetting.
There is no point in talking about this, Kate.
Why not?
Because the doorbell's ringing.
I'll get it.
Hi, Brett.
Hi, Jenny.
Hi, Kate.
Hi, Brett.
I'm sorry I didn't call.
Honey, that's perfectly all right. You know you're always welcome here.
Well, thank you. Actually, I came by to see Miles. I have to ask him something.
Well, Professor Rehnquist doesn't answer questions. Didn't you know that?
What would you like to ask him, Brett?
I want to know about High Topaz.
I'll make you a little bet. Your production division against mine. If I put you out of business in the next 6 months, we'll meet again. Right here. And you'll go to bed with me. Right in this hotel room.
What if I win?
I'll sell out Marshall Oil and leave Texas.
You're a liar.
No. I'm just sure of myself. Do we have a bet?
You've got a bet.
Are you still angry about last night?
You bet I'm angry.
Yeah, I guess you could say things are aces for us. Well, you certainly had the opportunity to invest. You should have taken advantage of it when I proposed it to you. Would you put that down? No, not you. You ever heard the expression, where were you when we needed you? Well, that's the way I feel. Would you stop that? Right. Well, we'll just talk to you soon then. Fine. Goodbye. Gregory, what are you doing here?
I'm supposed to meet Allison.
She went back to the hotel.
Then how am I going to get back?
I'll get Karen to take you back. Well, Gregory, what did you think of Houston?
It's okay.
Nothing about it interested you in any way?
No, sir, not really. Too much little kid stuff.
Is that right?
Houston's okay, but I've traveled all over the world.
Sorry I asked.
So, Marshall, what are you up to?
What'd you call me?
Marshall.
Gregory, don't you know it's rude to call people by their last name?
At school, we call everybody by their last name.
This isn't your school.
Then what am I supposed to call you?
Why don't you call me Mr. Marshall?
Mister? Sounds kind of funny to call someone in your family Mister.
All right. Then why don't you just call me Justin?
No.
It's my name.
Maybe I could call you Dad.
What?
I said I could call you Dad.
I am not your dad.
I never really had a father. Couldn't you just pretend that you're my father?
That's out of the question.
Oh.
Gregory, why don't you just pretend you're a nice, well-mannered little boy so I can get back to work here, all right? Bye. Gregory, what is it?
I'm hungry.
All right. I'm going to get Karen to take you back to the hotel so you can get something to eat. Now, does that meet with your approval?
That's fine. Thank you. You know something?
What?
You're really okay, Marshall.
Like Miles, does she?
That's putting it mildly.
Well, she's a very direct, straightforward woman. She probably doesn't understand someone as mysterious as Professor Rehnquist. So where is he anyway?
Oh, he's upstairs right now.
Oh, I'm gonna go talk to him.
Brett?
Yeah?
I'm not sure that's such a good idea.
Why not?
Well, he really doesn't want us asking questions about him. So why keep pushing?
Well, there's no harm in asking, is there?
No harm at all. Good to see you again, Brett.
I tried to tell Brett that you wouldn't answer any questions.
Gotta try.
Yeah, that's how she's getting along.
Oh, does that mean you're going to answer my questions?
Kinda depends on what the questions are.
I want to know what high topa is.
High topa?
Ever heard of it?
No, can't say I have. Why do you ask me?
Well, Ginny said that you kept repeating it over and over the night she found you.
I did? Sounds strange.
Does it mean anything at all to you?
Well, it sounds like an Indian word, but beyond that, no.
Well, I wonder why you kept repeating it. It must mean something.
I'm sure it does. Maybe I heard it somewhere or read it. It got stuck in my mind. Certainly doesn't mean anything now.
Well, I didn't think there was any harm in asking.
No harm. Sorry I couldn't be of more help.
Can I give you a hand with that, Kate?
Oh, no. Some fool trampled my flower bed, and I'm going to see if I can repair the damage.
Oh, no trouble at all, but Ginny, you'll have to go with us and give us directions.
Sure.
Okay, well, I'll just go and pull the car around and tell Kate what we're doing.
Thanks, Brett.
Sure.
I wish you didn't have to do this.
I have to, Ginny.
Well, stay here. You'll be safe here.
You won't. Look, I've already put you in enough danger.
I just hate the thought of you being all alone up there. If something happened, nobody would know.
Come on, Ginny, nobody's going to find me up there.
But if they do?
They're not. Now, please, don't worry.
Sorry, I can't help it. You've already been hurt. I mean, what makes you think they're going to give up?
Ginny, I'm running out of options. I've got to hide out till I get better. That cabin's my only chance.
Miles?
What?
High Topa is tied into this whole thing, isn't it? Okay, I'm sorry I'm not supposed to ask.
Ginny, I'd tell you more. You know I'd tell you more if I could. What I'm trying to do now is the most important thing that I've ever done in my life. I've got to succeed. Please, Ginny, believe me.
I do. But it scares me.
I'm gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss you too. And I'll come up and visit you and make sure you're all right, okay?
Good. That'll give me something to look forward to. I promise. You be careful.
I will. And you promise me that you'll come here for some home-cooked meals, okay?
Okay.
Everything's settled. You about ready, Dr. Rehnquist?
Sure thing.
Well, let me carry that.
Oh, I think I can manage.
Okay, well, let's move it out.
Okay.
Get on with your work.
Grant, there's got to be some way we can stop Justin.
It's too late. The deal is already signed, sealed, and delivered.
Are you telling me there's nothing we can do?
That's right. We couldn't make a bid because he had the money.
So, Ace High is his.
That's right. We've got to get another chance.
You bet we do. Actually, would have to inherit all that money.
It doesn't make any difference where the money came from. Justin has Ace High.
I can't think of anything more disgusting than Ashley with money.
What was her Aunt Hilde thinking about? Why didn't she have a foundation like Iris instead of throwing it away on someone like Ashley?
Wait, will you stop all this? I don't care about Ashley. I don't care about Justin. I don't care anything about anybody's Aunt Hilde.
But I do.
Well, you shouldn't. Now, you better forget about this hatred of Justin. Put that behind you.
I can't.
Well, you better. Or you won't be working for World Oil.
fire me?
You bet I will. Rena, I want you to think of Justin as just another executive in another oil company. Now, if you can, beat him. But don't you waste 1 ounce of energy trying to get even. You understand?
It's not that simple.
Oh, yes, it is. You just let go.
I can't let go, Grant. I've got to put Justin out of business in 6 months, and I swear I will.
I give you a piece of advice. Don't put a time limit on yourself.
I already have. Hi! How did everything go this high?
Just fine, darling.
Oh,
it's all ours.
Great! Everything's really going our way, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I'll accept one thing. Gregory paid me a visit this afternoon.
Isn't that sweet?
Well, no, it's not quite as sweet as you would think.
Why? What'd he do?
He bothered me.
Well, I'm sorry, Justin. I told Allison to take him straight back to the hotel.
Well, no, she was here. I told her she could go right on.
Justin, now please don't ever do that again. Don't go back behind me when I tell her to do something.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry about Gregory. What happened? Did he not have a good time on the tour?
Oh, well, no. Everything was just so childish for him.
What?
Well, he is a world traveler.
Oh, I'm sorry he didn't have a good time.
And he insisted on calling me Marshall.
Did you correct him?
Oh, yes. I told him that he could call me Justin, but he refused.
Why?
Well, he told me that everybody at his school calls everybody else by their last name.
Oh.
It's not funny, Ashley.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll have a talk with him, okay?
Yeah, I wish you would.
I think he really likes you, Justin.
Yeah, well, I don't like him.
I wish that you would try to be a little more understanding.
I don't know why, Ashley. I think he's a rotten kid.
How can you say that? Bless his heart, he's been through so much, Justin. His mother's gone. He's had to move to a city where he doesn't even know anybody. I feel so sorry for him, I could cry. I want to try to make it up to him, to both of them. And I want to have a family. And if you continue to act like this, I don't know what's going to happen.
Well, I'll try. I can't promise anything. I'll do my best to get along with a little monster.
Don't say that. Don't even think it, Justin. It means a lot to me.
I see that.
Justin, I know that you'll learn to love him.
Oh, hi, Steve. I bought some milk and cookies.
Okay.
All right, come on.
Okay.
Are you planning to come to the kitchen?
Yeah, sure. I was just thinking.
What about?
Professor Rehnquist.
What about him?
He's nice. I like him.
Oh, is that a fact? Come on.